Welcome all of you. In today's video lecture, we are going to discuss what is histamine and antihistamine meaning agents. So, what are the histamines? As we know that histamines are biogenic amine which are released as a response of autoimmune response. So, are they useful or harmful to us? For better understanding, we need to answer few questions. So let us start. So how they are synthesized in our body, how histamine released, and what is the physiological effect of histamine, what are the autoimmune response of histamine, and how antihistaminic agent neutralize the effect of antihistaminic agent. So we are going to discuss all these things in the further part of lecture. So, what are the histamine? Histamines are biogenic amine or organic nitrogenous compound which are released as an autoimmune response. So, histamines are one of the type of autacoids. So, what are the autacoids? Autacoids, as we know that autacoids are local hormones. They are synthesized locally and act locally. Therefore, they are called as a antihistamines or autacoids, okay, or local hormones. So this is the structure of histamine. Just note it down. Now let us discuss how histamine is synthesized in our body. Histamine is synthesized from naturally occurring amino acid L-histidine with the help of enzyme L-histidine decarboxylase. Histamine is stored in the mostly in the mast cell and basophils. So there is a prominent concentration of those cells in the skin, GI tract, then lungs and placenta. So why there is prominent presence of those cells in that particular body parts? Because those parts are more susceptible for the antigen antibody reaction, or we can say that autoimmune response. Therefore there is prominent presence of those cells in that region. So how they are released in our body, we are going to discuss that in the further. So after releasing of histamine, how they are react and what is the reaction of histamine with our body? So first of all, we need to understand what is the histamine, and after releasing of histamine, how they produce the histaminergic effect in our body. After releasing of any histamine, the histamine get released in our circulation, and then they get attached with the histaminic receptor in our body, and after they produce the inflammation, irritation and anaphylactic shock, such kind of allergic reactions that part. So how they produce that things, or how they produce that effect in our body? So whenever any antigen is entered into the body, so for the better understanding, I'll just explain this with the animation. Okay, so whenever we inhale, that air comes in the entered into the nasal path. After that, if the antigen is present in that part, that antigen get attached with the inner lining of nose, and at that inner lining of nose there are lymphocytes are present in that lining. So the lymphocyte, T lymphocyte, just send that message to the B lymphocytes. Then B lymphocyte have antibodies to particular that antigen. So that antigen get attached with that antibody which are present on the mast cell. So in that mast cell, due to the conjunction of antibody and antigen, the presence of granules in that basophil or mast cell eliminate the histamines, which produce the irritation or allergic reactions. The antihistamine drugs are compete with histamines for their receptor, and they just decrease the histaminic effect or inflammation or allergic reaction caused by the histamine. So therefore, the mechanism of antihistaminic drug is to decrease the number of histamine receptor by competing with histamines. First generation antihistaminic agents are further classified into 8 types. So the first type of first generation H1 receptor antagonist is amino alkyl ether. After that, the second type is ethylene diamine derivatives. So the further type of H1 receptor antagonist is piperazine derivative, and the next is propylamine derivative. So the fifth is phenothiazine derivative, and sixth is imidazolone derivative, and the next is piperidine derivative, and the last is miscellaneous drug. So these are the subtypes of H1 receptor antagonist, first generation H1 receptor antagonist. So the structural activity relationship of those drugs we are going to learn. For that, we have to understand the basic structure of H1 receptor, first generation H1 receptor antagonist. So that basic structure of H1 receptor antagonist are divided into four parts. So that four parts we are going to discuss now. Now you can see the basic structure of antihistaminic H1 receptor antagonist. So that basic structure is divided into four parts. So the first part is aryl group. After that aryl group, there is a X junction, and X junction is attached with the spacer. In that spacer, there is a carbon chain. After that, there is a nitrogen terminal. So that all part is essential, or this is the part of basic structure of H1 receptor antagonist first generation drugs. Okay, so at the aryl group, there may be phenyl or substitute phenyl or pyridyl ring are attached at the aryl group. Okay, then the next is X junction. At the X junction, there may be nitrogen, carbon atom or alkyl amines are attached at the X junction. After that, the next part is spacer. The spacer usually 2 to 3 carbon in length, and it may be in a ring, may be branched, and may be structured or unstructured. So the next part is R group. Okay, so R group attached to the aliphatic amine usually are simple alkyl groups, generally methyl, occasionally alkyl groups. So this is all parts is essential, or this we need to understand all these parts of the basic structure to understand the structural activity relationship of any H1 receptor antagonist, first generation H1 receptor antagonist. So
In amino alkyl ether or amino alkyl derivative, the structure, as we know, that divided into four subtype. In the amino alkyl ether, the amino alkyl ether characterized by the presence of CHO connecting moiety at X junction. Okay, so at X junction there is CHO moiety is connected. Okay, then two or three carbon chains linking moiety between the diaryl and tetraryl amino group. Okay, that means at the spacer or on the place of carbon chain, there is 2 to 3 carbon chain is present in amino alkyl ether. Okay, then next is, most of the compound in the series are simple NN dimethylene amine derivatives. Okay, so now we are going to discuss, if there is fluctuation in the structure, basic structure of H1 receptor antagonist, what will be happen, if whether there is increase in histaminergic property or there is decrease of histaminergic property of antihistaminic drug. So let us discuss. As we know that, okay, so substitution of CH3 OCH3 ClBr at the para position on one of the phenyl ring of diphene okay, diphenhydramine leads to the better activity and less side effects than diphenhydramine. Okay, so that means substitution of those enlisted group at the para position. As we know that, where is the para position? As I discussed earlier, para position, okay, meta para, ortho meta para, those are the position on that phenyl ring. So at the para position, if we substitute those group, then it will increase the antihistaminic property of our drug and decrease the other side effects. Then next is replacement of one of the phenyl ring of the diphenhydramine with 2-pyridyl group in doxalamine enhance the antihistaminic activity by 2 times. Okay, 2-doxalamine, that means, as I think you already knew about the doxalamine structure. Okay, 2-pyridyl, where is 2-pyridyl? We have to, okay, in that ring, if there is nitrogen is present in the phenyl ring, that means that is 2-pyridyl. Okay, then next is some compounds such as clemistine and diphenpyrrolidine differs from the basic structure pattern in this compounds. The basic nitrogen moiety and some parts of the carbon chain are in the form of heterocyclic ring system. Okay, so we know that N-terminal is most important part of the antihistaminic property. Now we are going to discuss one drug which is associated with first generation amino aryl ether group. Okay, so first generation H1 receptor blocker, amino alkyl ether group. So what is the drug? Diphenhydramine hydrochloride is belongs to amino alkyl ether. Okay. So now you can see the structure of diphenhydramine hydrochloride. In that structure, there is two phenyl ring at X junction. Okay. So at X junction, there is carbon atom which is linked with hydrogen. Okay. Then that carbon is linked with further carbon chain. Okay. Then N terminal and ethyl group. Ethylene group. Okay, so this is the structure of diphenhydramine hydrochloride. So what are the uses of diphenhydramine? As we know that diphenhydramine hydrochloride is a H1 receptor antagonist, so we can say that it is used as a antihistaminic agent. So this is the end of today's video lecture. I worked hard for making this video lecture. If you like today's video, please hit the like button, and if you are new on my channel, please subscribe and share this video to your friends and family. Thanks.